Just gonna check that that it's on and sounds all right because seems good. Right, so I've created this mission and we're about to go. I normally fly in VR, but I decided in the end to get myself a Track AR simply because you couldn't really stream in VR, and there's a load of other things I wanted to do with it. So it's spring 43, and the German Air Force is starting to lose numbers, although there's still enough to defend occupied territory against smaller enemy attacks. Today, we are assigned one wingman to patrol the area with us. So it's take off and follow the route, and there are expected to be some threats. So it's a cold and dark start-up, and I'm going to run through it. So I'm going to push these in and some of those in up until we'll get the UV lights and the nav lights, and we'll not go any further because that's heating and so much we don't want to run off the battery. I'm going to take the gun sight off because we don't need that. I'm going to open the start switch ready. I'm going to, where's the fuel? There we go. Going to crack the throttle and open the radiators, and with that, ask the ground crew to start spinning up the prop, get the mags on, and as soon as we hear it spinning right, I'm going to add the fuel. Hear it winding up. There we go, it's ready. Hold the brakes down, engage the starter. And we got it, release the starter. Shut the starter. And I've never actually done any dogfighting yet in VR. And I can see right away this gun sight. This gun is in the way of some of these switches. Don't need the pitot heat, but we do need that generator. So I'm happy with that. And with that, looks like my wingman's got started up as well. Keep the tail wheel unlocked and we'll begin taxiing. Have a look at the situation. So there we are, we're on the ground. It's a small airfield. And
contact armored target 2 o'clock.
No, it's such an eager beaver, we'll let him go first. Real life, these props are hard to see over. We'll do the old side to side. Oh, he's made a distance. Some explosions in the distance. Gonna shut the radiator because we want the engine to warm up a bit, and it's quite cool today. Early spring, early March, I think it's at 10 degrees. Myself the red nose. It's a bit like the red nosed BF, not the BF, the yeah, the 190, the Focke Wulf, sorry, the FW190 has that nice red nose. For some reason, this red nose here on the 109 and this, well, this entire paint scheme, this livery, is not available in contemporary times, it's just a World War II. So if you go to World War II times, type in that in the date, you get this list. More modern, we don't, so. How are we doing on that engine? Just about over the start limit now, so I'm gonna open the valves. I'll set them for auto once more. Flaps are up. Don't want them. I'm going to trim the nose down a little bit. Roll in. whole day waxing.
Thank you.
let's have a quick look. Yeah, Cherbourg. Port Milly. Yes, that's the thing.
Join them.
again like that. Why are you rejoining? Oh, he's jumped out. On an RAF parachute. Thank you. stand on... No, I'm not actually. I'm not even going to stand on it. Right, there we go. I pull the stick back to try and fight it, but I've lost authority. Why? Because it's a stall. Why is it stalling? Because we've lost control. What is the stall speed? Let's see if we can find the stall speed. It's not much under 200 kilometers an hour. So I'm going to try hold it. I'm going to try there. Hold it, hold it, hold it, hold it. I'm starting to buff it. Hold it, hold it. 150. I've still got hold of it, but it's really shaking. 140, I'm pulling it back, using a lot of rudder dancing to try it. In fact, I'm stalling there, just holding the wing onto the wings with rudder. So 160, we were still sort of stalling, but... speed and you've got no flight controls there at all. So have that ability with the prop just to control the roll and the guard just a little bit of problem. When you have no other control than the other way, it's a hand, it's helpful. Like, do you understand that if I add power it's going to go this way, if I turn power off it's going to go that way. That is the only means to control. You have a few seconds while you're in that belt fight. You have the knowledge to know I'm going to go this way or that way. And meanwhile, the other guy doesn't know those things, but he's going to do that. So yeah, going over some of these things, in some cases, when it's really, you know, if you draw a green or a plane on a piece of paper, some lines at the end, but it's really, those of us who don't know these things, it's right to help you. You get up to speed with PCS, good problem. Good. You know what, while we're waiting for the enemy, can I get this guy? This is all control. That would have been a lot easier than we are. These are nice touches on the Normandy maps. These were sort of the tunnel complexes where the Germans were hiding and looking out for when the invasion was coming. I don't know. No, this is... This is like... I used to think the contract I had, it was... Now that is a huge planet. Bye. how it was, and they said the ration back then included 2 cigarettes a week, as well as the pay. Everybody got 2 cigarettes a week, and you never smoke. So he said he'd gone through the entire war without spending any money on this trade. Because he would trade everyone at the very end, including the enemy, for a cigarette. So once they occupied Japan and all that stuff, he came back with the samurai sword and all those things he was trading with cigarettes that he would smoke. So they learned that what was going to happen at war, and set the book to his shop that he banned when I was a little boy. So yeah. F10 map. Yeah, here we are, and here's the airbase. In fact, there's an enemy up there. We'll be right back. I don't know what the Messerschmitt procedure is, but I'm going to assume it's the same. So these bars are right. Flaps now.